What's up, y'all? It's the Maginai. It's time for another one. So today we are doing some Star Wars news. I know it's been a while. You know, the leader, Captain Marvel thing's been, you know, draining up a lot of my time. But don't worry, we're not escaping Captain Marvel completely. But anyway, we have an article today from our good friend Scotty Mendelson over there at Forbes magazine. And the title of this new article is Why the Success of Captain Marvel is a Terrific News for the Star Wars Episode 9. Yes! Two birds, one stone. So, let's get into this real quick and then I'll discuss what I feel about this right now. The broad success of Brie Larson, Samuel Jackson / Reggie the Cat movie, again with this cat thing. Listen, I don't want to, you know, if you're a nice cat puppy lover, that's great. But, you know, the cat films and stuff, that's cool when you're like, I don't know, whatever. But not everybody's into cats like that. I mean, they're cool. They're cool and everything. I had cats as a kid. But just saying, when you're trying to make a blockbuster movie, your focus shouldn't be on the cat. Why is the cat's name there anyway? I'm just saying. But anyway. Means, yet again, that the trolls had no effect on the film's public reception. This thing right there uses means yet again the trolls had no effect on the film's public perception. I'm confused because there was really nothing that really was going against this movie other than the fact that people were saying again you may have a small amount of people out there who feel some kind of way about female superheroes. But that's not the case with the people who's been being the loudest about Brie Larson and Captain Marvel. You know, she did her thing with the whole Wrinkle in Time statement, which I was like, okay, that wasn't the smartest thing to do. You know, you shouldn't do things like that. You're trying to, you know, you shouldn't bring things like that up. Just saying. Whatever. That really wasn't what got me. What really got me was what happened after the fact, which was the Rotten Tomatoes thing, the YouTube thing, and, you know, everything else that went along with it. And, of course, with the YouTube thing / what they were doing to Alita, that's what really got me more, you know, PO'd about this whole situation. If anything else, you know, I love female superheroes. I mean, we wanted a Black Widow movie a long time ago. As a matter of fact, if you really wanted to bring up a super-powered female-led superhero, Scarlet Witch. Even though you tweaked her powers, but Scarlet Witch is so powerful that she said no more mutants, and that happened. I'm just saying. Think about that. But anyway, let's continue with this. That means that while they won't stop shouting, we don't necessarily have to give them a bullhorn or include them in serious elements of the critical narrative. What the internet thinks about something, especially when it's merely a handful of tweets or Facebook posts, which we'll get into that in a minute, isn't indicative of the general movie-going populace. If it were, Mad Max Fury Road would have cleared $400 million global, and Bohemian Rhapsody wouldn't have been an Oscar-winning $878 million grossing smash. What this means is that folks over at Lucasfilm, especially Kathleen Kennedy and J.J. Abrams, can breathe a sigh of relief. So I want to piggyback on something I heard Odin say, which she was correct. Odin's movie blog, check him out. If you haven't, just saying, you probably should. He said one of the things he made a mistake on as far as, you know, the MCU versus Star Wars, that Star Wars fans in general have had X amount of years, about 40 or so years, and within that 40 years, Disney has only been dealing with it for the last, what they got, 2012 they bought it, I mean, not even a decade, you know, not even, nowhere near it, but with the MCU, they've had 11 years of that same core audience, is the same people who went there to see this movie, and with that being said, that's why you're going to have that. Star Wars is a totally different animal. Star Wars, again, like I've mentioned before, and this is, you know, anecdotal. When I talk about Star Wars to my cousins' kids, my nieces, nephews, everybody out there, is very little people who care about Star Wars. And this isn't my circle of friends. But you multiply that by the amount of people out there. You say that by, you talk about the MCU and Marvel, that's a whole different story. There's a lot of people who are on the, you know, the Star Wars, I mean, Marvel train. Not a lot of people who's on the Star Wars train. So those people that you have on the Star Wars train, that's it. And, you know, you screwed up big time, Lucasfilm. Big time. We're not going to go over that just yet because we already, you know, we've been over this 1,000 times. You guys screwed that up. Well, Marvel's a totally different story. So, again, you're going to have those people who are more, like, you know, the kids younger than me or whatever will be more interested in the MCU. You know, you have the other people who are, like, you know, diehard comic fans. Obviously, again, piggybacking off what Odin said, those people are not really in their equation anymore because they realize right now, of course, again, when we're saying this movie made so much money, it's been so much. I did 3 videos already showing empty seats for a movie that's supposed to be this big blowout thing. Huge blowout thing. But you have empty seats all over the place. That's either here or there. Is Disney buying seats? Whatever happened to the Captain Marvel challenge? You know, the kids they're supposed to go to. I haven't seen or heard anything about that. Nothing on Twitter. You would think they've been, with all this patting themselves on the behind, that this thing is, you know, blowing up the box office. Where was the pictures of all these, you know, underprivileged kids going to see Captain Marvel? If anybody's seen that, let me know. Shoot me an email or something. Let me know if you've seen that. I want some, you know, physical evidence of where this money went. Because last time I checked, if you're buying stuff and just and it's not really going anywhere else but back to Disney anyway, I'm just saying that's a small little bit, but I'm not saying that was the whole thing. Yeah, you're gonna have a lot of the popcorn movie people going just to see this movie because it says MCU on it. That's where you're gonna have that from. But totally different when it comes to Star Wars, and this is what's different with Star Wars. You squandered your opportunity to have Han, Luke, and Leia together. We are never going to forgive you for that. I am never going to forgive you for that. And these new characters that you put out there, nobody likes them. It's nothing to do about their race, nothing to do about their gender. They're just poorly written characters. Bottom line. And I'm really tired of having to repeat myself that, you know, is when you have a difference of opinion, it doesn't make you a troll. Trolls just say things to piss people off. When I say, hey, Rey is not necessarily the best character, never mind the fact that she's a female, forget that part, it's not the best character, you say, oh, you're just being a troll. That is not how you have a conversation. So, let's move along. So, with that being said, and the whole thing as far as, you know, they have a sigh of relief. This is coming from my good friend over in Twitter, Ruin Johnson. He put up a tweet. It says, Dead Luke Skywalker has less than 10 minutes of screen time in the final episode of the 9-movie, 40-year-long Skywalker saga. Show me your feelings in a gif, in the form of a gif. So he put, not amused. I'm going to tell you like this here. Right? If Luke Skywalker, you already did the whole killing him off thing, and I'm pretty sure you're doubling down on that. If Luke Skywalker has 10 minutes of showtime, you might as well just say, we're not making any more Star Wars movies. Just, because we, look, I knew going in, and I'm repeating this from several videos I did before. I knew going in, Mark Hamill's getting old, Harrison Ford's getting old. At the time Carrie Fisher was alive, she's getting old. We knew we weren't going to get 10 movies out of them. We knew this. We knew at some point they were gonna either get killed off or pass the torch of some sort. What should have happened is that you should have had these new characters in there, introduced them, and slowly let them take over. You didn't even have to kill anybody off. That was totally unnecessary. Just because you're passing the torch doesn't mean you have to kill the teacher or the master. You don't have to kill the person off who was holding the torch first to proceed with the story. It could have just been, you know, Leia just went totally into politics. You know, Han was being a good husband and a general, and Luke just became, you know, a teacher. Didn't do any of the active things. He stayed on the council, didn't really do anything. If he had to do anything, he could have just did it, you know, locally. He didn't have to go do missions or anything like that. They could have did that. But no, you want to go with the killing people off, because remember, you guys said it. Get rid of past. Kill it if you have to. Well, you know what I mean. Get rid of the past. That stupid quote. That was y'all. That was y'all doing that. So, I'm just saying, if Luke Skywalker, after all of this, because he's literally gotten, you might as well say he got no real screen time, because what did he get in Episode 7? Nothing. That travesty of a freaking film, the abomination that you put in The Last Jedi, that was not Luke Skywalker, okay? So, I'm just going to go by forget the sequel trilogy. Luke has got no real airtime at all. He got beat by a student who a day ago, had never held a lightsaber, got beat by Luke. I don't care. He slipped on the rocks, whatever. He was letting her win. He didn't want to use the force. I don't care. I've already made this discussion before when I showed you what Yoda did to Ventress, who is a trained dark side user. He literally took her lightsaber away from her like it was nothing. Luke didn't have to, he didn't have to beat her, he just had to disarm her and show her who's boss. That's all he had to do, but he didn't do that. He got beat by a student. So, what I'm going to say is, if Luke Skywalker has 10 minutes of runtime on that movie, I mean, it's already to the point that I'm probably going to see Cats instead, or Jumanji. I'm leaning towards that. I don't know how I want to see Episode 9, but if that is the case, you might as well just put a fork in it. Just put a fork in it, because you're done. Because you're not going to get the same amount of dedication from these new fans with Star Wars. Star Wars, again, was more, it had, you know, depth to it. It wasn't flashy lights. Yeah, they had some flashy lights and stuff in the prequel era. That's because we were still moving along with, you know, that instant gratification. Even though, don't get me wrong, I like the prequels. You know, I didn't hate them. I still say Episode 3 is the better of the three. But the original Star Wars was more thought-provoking and things like that. It wasn't all flashy lights and stuff like how you have the MCU. Not saying anything's wrong with that. But you're never going to get the same amount of people, the same kind of fan base that you have with the MCU that you had with Star Wars with the original fans. It's never going to happen. If it does, I'll say I'm wrong. But I don't think, at least not in my lifetime, I don't think it's going to happen like that. Not unless they do some serious course correction, which, by the way, the whole thing about the trolls had no effect. Why did Bob Iger get up there and say he had to do some course correction? If everything was fine, don't think just because Captain Marvel did good. Remember, doing good at the box office doesn't mean it's a good movie. Ask the Transformers movies. That doesn't mean you had a good movie, alright? Just remember that. But here's the one thing before I get out of here. Last night I was listening to World Class BS. And they were talking about the whole trolling of, well, not even trolling, but it was the doxing of Adam Driver and his wife. And they were doing some really nasty things, which none of us in the Fandom Menace condone whatsoever. And that's the same thing I said when it came down to the whole alleged Kelly Retran thing. None of us condone that stuff, okay? Why aren't those people being put on blast and being called out for the nonsense that they are? The people who are, you know, doing the vile things they're doing to Adam Driver. But when we say, hey, we didn't like your movie, whether it be Captain Marvel, Star Wars, whatever, we are the trolls. I want y'all to think about that. Think about that. Why is that? But anyway, how do y'all feel about the situation? Do you think that Captain Marvel has defeated us? Do you think that she's defeated the people who don't agree Because I'm not even going to call us trolls. We're not the trolls. Because if anything, the mainstream media, the trolls, they're the ones who are always trying to elicit us some kind of a response from us, the fans. Or are you like, eh, whatever. Let me know in the comments. Like, share, and subscribe. And of course, hit that notification bell so you get my vids when I drop them. I catch y'all later. Peace. I can't quit. I'm heartless. You bullshit.